A very good morning to you all. Welcome back after the summer break. We shall be discussing today about fertilization. It is just the continuation of the chapter pollination and fertilization. Now, in the previous topic, what we had discussed about pollination, it is the transfer of pollen grains from the anther to the stigma of the flower. Clear? Now, when after pollination, what is the next event? That is the germination of the pollen grain. Clear? Now, before moving further, we shall discuss about the pollen grain. Pollen grain is what? Male gamete. How does it develop? See, this first diagram, what do you observe? This is a structure of a pollen grain. Just a pollen grain, resting pollen grain. It has an outer surface which is not continuous, having spiny structure called as axine. The inner layer is called as intine and it is continuous. And it has cytoplasm and nucleus. Nucleus is of two types. One is tube nucleus and generative nucleus. But what happens after the pollen grains germinate? What happens? This part is the style, stigma, style and ovary. You can observe here the pollen grains after germinating form an elongated pollen tube. What happens? The intine, it pours out, it forms a tube-like structure. How is it possible? There are pores in between the axine. I said it is not continuous. So through these pores or germ pores, the intine, they form a tube-like structure. And along with the nucleus, it forms a tube. So, the pollen grain, as it forms a pollen tube, it starts moving towards the ovary. Clear? Now, the nucleus, which is of two types, tube nucleus and generative nucleus. Clear? Now, the germinating pollen grain, after it has become matured, what do you observe? The tube nucleus, what is the function? It directs the male gamete or the male nuclei towards the micropyle. The generative nucleus divides into two and forms the two male gamete or two male nuclei. Let us again come back to this diagram. So you see, as the pollen tube is directed towards the embryo sac, how does it get its nutrition? It gets its nutrition by digesting the sugars secreted by the style and the enzymes, and it is directed towards the embryo sac. What is the structure of embryo sac? Embryo sac, this is the ovary and the ovule. Now, what do you find? The embryo sac, it has a cell structure having micropylar end and chalazal end. You can see three cells here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So the embryo sac is an 8 cell structure in the primary stage. What happens as the pollen tube reaches the micropyle? What is micropyle? It is the opening through which the male gamete will enter the embryo sac. It has got two polar nuclei in the middle and one egg cell and two synergids. Got it? You can see here also. Now, what is in angiosperm, that is flowering plants, fertilization is said to be double fertilization. Clear? Why? See, there are two male nuclei. So, what happens? One of the male nuclei will enter the micropyle. What is micropyle? As I have said earlier, it is the opening through which the male gamete enters the embryo sac and fuses with the egg cell, resulting in the formation of zygote that will develop into the actual embryo and later into plant. What happens to the second male gamete? It moves further and fuses with the two polar nuclei. Before fusion, these two polar nuclei will fuse and form two end structure. So the male nuclei which fuses with these two polar nuclei, that forms the secondary nucleus or 3N, that is triple fusion, 2N plus N, 3N. clear? That will develop into endosperm that provides nourishment for the growing embryo. Now, what happens? That is, this part is the ovule. What happens after fertilization? The ovary will develop into fruit. Ovary wall into fruit wall. Ovule, that is the zygote which had formed, it will develop into seed. And what happens? The sepals, petals, they all wither and fall off. Even calyx and corolla. But in some plants you find the calyx is persistent as in the brinjal. Clear? So accordingly you have to be familiar with the diagram. In the exams you most probably will be asked to either draw a structure of a pollen grain, or you may be asked to label it, all these diagrams and the related questions. Clear? Let me give you some notes. So this is fertilization. You have to remember the definitions as what is fertilization, what is syngamy, why, what do you mean by double fertilization? One sperm nuclei fuses with the egg cell forming zygote. The second male nuclei or male gamete will fuse with the polar nuclei forming endosperm or secondary nucleus. Therefore, it is called as double fertilization. Clear? Then accordingly, you may be asked what is the function of stigma, what is the function of style, what is the function of the ovary, ovules, all those types. And what is the function of exine and intine? Exine are protective in function. They have a thick chemical that is secretion called as sporopollenin. So after the tube, they reach the end of the, that is the opening of the embryo sac, the tube nucleus becomes disorganized, that is disintegrates, while the genetic nucleus behind it divides into two male gamete or two male nuclei. So the tube nucleus doesn't have any role in fertilization, only that it directs the pollen tube towards the micropylar end, so that the male gamete can enter the embryo sac. The seed coat develops from the integuments, which are the covering, and the nucleus also is laden with food. You may be asked the function of the, separately, what is the function of endosperm? And in monocots, the endosperm, the seed stores the food in endosperm, and in dicots, the food is stored in the cotyledon. That's for